Hello friends, right now I am seated in front of one of the most dignified guests that the cotton fraternity has had in recent times. I am right now with Mr. Salman Ispahani, the president of International Cotton Association, most famously known as the ICA. Welcome, Mr. Salman.
Thank you, Manish.
Mr. Salman, let us start with you are the newly elected president of ICA. So what are the main targets that you have set in mind that you wish to do in your tenure?
Well, as you know, ICA is a very old association, over 175 years old. So I hope to be able to continue the good work that's been done by my predecessors. It's important to let people know we're just basically an arbitral body.
Right.
And our main theme is sanctity of contract.
Absolutely.
So this is what I need to disseminate to all members in all different sectors of the value chain, that once you sign a contract, it's important that you perform.
Absolutely, because you have signed it with your full willing.
obviously.
Right. No, it's a good thought, because the current trade is struggling with that, the contracts entity, in spite of everybody knowing it is part of business. They must perform the contract, but still there is struggle, and ICA is here to disseminate that or mitigate the risk. And Mr. Salman, as the newly elected president, has taken upon himself that he will try and ensure that this positive attitude of performing the contract spreads to more and more people.
No, it's important that all members realize and they understand. We are just basically rules and bylaws by which 90% of all cotton international contracts are governed.
Right.
It's important everyone understands when they enter the contract what their obligations are and what their rights are. Absolutely. It works both ways.
Right, it goes both
and
ways.
They need to perform. It's not that every contract or even the majority of contracts fail. There's a very minority of contracts where there can be problems for many reasons. It's
right.
Just that we know how to solve the problem. Normally it's solved much before it gets to arbitration. But if it needs to go to arbitration, people should understand that the rules were clear, they're understandable, they're transparent, and they are impartial. That's very important.
That's very important, yes. Rules have to be neutral and impartial. So, taking it up from here, belonging to Asia, a very strategic player in production and consumption, do you have any specific plans for Asia?
Nothing specific for Asia. You know, there is a bit of a language barrier. So we've ensured, the ICA has ensured even before my time, that the rules have been translated into the regional languages. We carry out a lot of training in both consuming and producing countries to let people know, to let them understand. And we have various country focus groups. We've got spinners groups who voice their concerns if they have any feeling that certain rules may need slight tweaking or changing because of the needs of the time. And the board has formed a board committee which has looked into these things, and after due deliberation they put up the recommendations to the board. So it's an evolving, it's a dynamic rule. It's evolving, it keeps changing where it's necessary to change.
Absolutely.
And that is something for the region at least, it's important to understand, because the region when we travel, they always have a feeling that because it's a very old association, it used to be the Liverpool Cotton Association, it was formed by a certain section of the value chain, which is not really true anymore. You see that
it may have been, but right, yes, and, you say it has evolved over the time.
Evolved over the time, and so the rules need to be seen to be transparent and impartial. And that's what I think is our target, and we continue to work towards that.
Right. So, again, from there, you are, I think, maybe one of the first consumers, or maybe one of the very few consumers who has, grown to be the president.
So this underlines the evolution of the association itself.
Absolutely.
That they've seen that we are actually a neutral body. We're just an arbitral body. We have rules and bylaws, as I said earlier, and people trade under these rules and bylaws. So whoever is the president at the time, he cannot do anything that different, cannot change the rules and bylaws because I'm a consumer or if I'm a merchant or a controller. I can't change anything. It's there. It needs the whole approval of the board. It needs to be voted in by the members, any changes.
Right.
So it's not a simple thing we do very easily that, let's just change this rule. It goes through a whole process.
Yeah, but it creates a ray of hope. You being a consumer, you being from the consumer industry, now you are the president of an apex body for arbitration, whose bylaws are respected world over.
I find a lot of encouragement in my travels. You know, I've been to Vietnam, you know, of course from Bangladesh,
right.
And people now do come up to me and say, you know, and they're encouraged. We are encouraging members from all sections. We want more and more members. I've been talking to the Cotton Association of India in the last couple of days, as you've seen, and
right.
We've had this dialogue going for many years now, and the relationship is getting closer, which is very important because being such a major producer and
right.
And a contributor to international trade of cotton,
absolutely.
It's important that ICA is on board with any of their concerns, and if they have any such concerns, I'll take it back to the board and have further discussions on that.
Right. So now your visit very timely. The CAI recently has a new elected body, and they are very proactive. So you recently met the board. So anything that we can expect?
No, we've been very overwhelmed by the very kind response you've had. You know, they've had looked after us very well. It's a very short visit. It's important I came now because we have a new managing director at the ICA.
Right.
And it's important he meets people face to face. So he's the person who will have continuity. We have 1 year terms as president,
right.
And Bill Kington is an accomplished person. So when you have a name, face to the name, when you want
yes.
to contact somebody, the ICA, and he knows people at this end. And this is a continuation of an annual visit of the last few years as part of my MOU that the president and some the MD etc. will visit and continue discussion.
It's a good initiative that you took immediately after the Bangladesh summit. The President MD visiting India, meeting the Cotton Association of India board members, getting into interaction for future mutually beneficial relationship. So, anything that we can expect happening between ICA and CAI in the near future?
No, we raise certain issues that, regarding arbitrators. We have very few arbitrators from the region.
Right.
So CAI has assured us that they will persuade some of their members to do the course, qualify, and to become part of the ICA panel of arbitrators. That's important.
Okay.
Secondly, we discussed having an ICA Bremen accredited lab under the control of the CAI. It's a long process. It's a lot of detailed work needs to be done, drawings, etc.,
right.
The infrastructure to be built, and the CI is very keen. It's not the first time we've discussed this, and I think this time they're very serious to start work going
absolutely.
On this. The certain CI also has their own rules. They've assured us they will look into whether there are any differences between the ICA and CI rules. They'll try to adopt the ICA rules, and where they feel that it is necessary for ICA to revisit some of their rules, if necessary. We will have a look. We have a rules committee.
Yes.
We said if you have any members of CAI who are members of ICA who are interested to serve, we will put it up to the chairman of the rules committee to take them on board so they can work from the inside and understand
absolutely.
How things happen at the ICA.
No, it was a good thing that you suggested that let somebody from CAI be part of the rules committee so that they know the rules and we can synchronize the rules of both
correct.
Associations.
Correct.
As a company from Bangladesh, you are from strategically one of the big, not one, the biggest importer of raw cotton in the world. Right now, you are in a country which is the biggest producer of cotton in the world. We share a common border between India and Bangladesh. How do you see that we develop a healthy business relationship between these two countries?
Well, as you've seen in the recent past, a large proportion of our imports come from India.
Right.
I think this year was about 50%.
Yes.
It's not high, and it makes a lot of sense. It's so close. Regionally, we don't have to hold huge stocks. The shipments come in very quickly. And we're getting more and more used to using the cotton. But there are concerns that, there are delays. We have congestion to the port, also in the land port. The congestion, as you mentioned in your presentation to the Global Summit in Dhaka. The concerns from the other side of timely payments against documents or against LCs, which sometimes it gets delayed, which unfortunately people are factoring into their costs now. So the whole industry in Bangladesh is paying a slightly higher price because
yes.
everyone is being
everybody is not making delayed payment, but
so this is something I will take up with the association back home and mention to them and see how they can work with the banks and see this has not happened because it's not right. The quality issues, serious quality issues, which need to be addressed from your side. We've raised that with the CAI.
Right.
quality being an agricultural commodity is possible that there'll be variations, but we need to be sure that what we contracted for, we do receive. And it happens sometimes that for the change of policies, imports maybe get curtailed or stopped, and we cannot rely on that cotton being part of our portfolio. And there, you know, cotton is produced in many places in the world.
That's right.
And once we get used to somewhere else, it'll be very difficult for the Indian cotton industry to come back.
Absolutely.
In the picture. As you've seen, West African cotton is taking, have made major inroads
in
our market in a very
short
period of time, and the cotton is very good. The shipments are not bad, and we don't have those real serious quality issues that we're getting. So that's something of concern.
It costs extra, but the mills don't mind paying it.
Because the quality issues are not there. We don't want to get any surprises.
Absolutely.
So that's something you need to really consider.
Surprises, pleasant are okay, but unpleasant are really painful. Because in industry, you have very minimal margins. It's a capital intensive industry.
Yes, it's very difficult for any, even one shipment sets you back a long time.
I agree with you, yes. So what Mr. Salman strongly advocates is walk the talk. And we should all be doing business based on contracts. Contract is a must, but simultaneously sanctity of contract. Without that, this business is not going to grow the way it has to. Thank you, Mr. Salman.
Thank you very much, Mr. Salman. Thank you very much.
To us, share our views.
Thank you.
We really appreciate it.
Thanks a lot. Thank you very much. Thanks.
Focus on anything you want to